The day before yesterday, Apple suddenly released a Mac with M3 series. M3, M3 Pro, and M3 Max were released for the first time. The Mac Studio and Mac Pro software of M2 Ultra cores just bought 3 times ago have not been installed yet. Maybe Tim Cook considers that there is no change in the appearance of M1 Max to M2 Max, so that when you go to Starbucks, you won't recognize it. Wow, the new MacBook Pro. Okay, there's a lot of nonsense. Next, let's get down to business. The version we got is the top MacBook Pro of M3 Max Core. In fact, many YouTube has tested the changes related to core testing, video cutting, and game playing. Let's help you test it in depth from the actual situation in the field of music frequency. First of all, many music lovers, music enthusiasts, and music practitioners say that the quality of Mac's sound card and playback is actually very good. So this time, we helped our family to measure the specific data of Mac's onboard sound card and playback. In this test, we used the cable to connect the Mac computer to the Symphony desktop sound card of Apogee through the 3.5 connection, and then through the RMAA software for testing. First part of the DA output dynamic range of the test, in theory, the output dynamic range, the better the quality. The new MacBook Pro with the M3 Max core shows 108.1 dBA. At the bottom of the list is the Mac Studio with M2 Ultra core, which is similar to the MacBook Air with the original M1 core. In fact, the DA output dynamic range of the built-in sound card can achieve such performance, which is close to, or even beyond, many 1,000 yuan sound cards. I also show the output dynamic parameters of this hot professional sound card. The 108.1 dBA of the new MacBook Pro with M3 Max Core is the same as that of the SSL 2 Plus, worth $349, even more than that of the Yamaha UR22C worth $239, which is often unexpected. Let's move on to the noise floor data and THD, the lower the number, the cleaner the sound. The M3 Max Core MacBook Pro has a noise floor of 108.3 dB and a THD of 0.0006%, which is worth $659. Hot sound card RME Babyface Pro FS is better. Poor performance is still the Mac Studio with M2 Ultra Core. Maybe Apple thinks that if you buy Studio, can't you afford to buy an external sound card? On the contrary, the Mac Mini data performance of M2 Pro Core is really good. Maybe this kind of household group wants it more. So Apple gets it. The latency performance of the sound card is also a concern for many music producers and related practitioners. Due to the PCIe channel of the new Mac onboard sound card, the MacBook Pro of M3 Max and M2 Max is under buffer size 32. Logic Pro shows a low input delay of only 1.8 ms and an output delay of only 3.9 ms, which is comparable to the delay data of the same PCIe channel Thunderbolt sound card, surpassing the delay data of many USB sound cards. We additionally tested the Intel MacBook Pro with an output latency of 18.1 mems. This year's upgrade is really quite obvious, not to mention the built-in onboard sound card cannot be delayed. However, it is worth mentioning that this low latency is theoretically not related to the core, but only to the quality of the built-in sound card installed in Macs of different ages and prices. Since Apple launched the MacBook Pro with M1 Max Core in 2021, the playback quality of Mac has been improved, and the promotion has also been enhanced. And Apple's push will fluctuate according to the different impedance machines you connect. According to our actual measurement, when the machine is connected to the impedance of 150 ohms, the push is about 4.2 dB. However, when the machine is connected to the impedance of 150 ohms, the push is close to 12 dB. In fact, this can already push a machine like the Sennheiser HD650 at 300 ohms, such as the DT8 Hozare. This 600 ohm machine is also no problem. This push can basically beat the public release on the side of the public sound card, has surpassed the SSL 2 Plus and Yamaha UR22C2 to $300 sound card release push, close to the push of RME Babyface Pro FS. Because of this adaptive push function, the low impedance machine does not need to adjust the computer too much, sacrificing the dynamic range of the original music. The previous double push collocation has also been used on Babyface Pro FS. The 3.5 mm hole is plus 7 dB. The hole of 6.35 mm is plus 13 dB, which is also used to adapt to machines with different impedances. After measuring the performance of the built-in sound card and amplifier of the Mac, we can really catch up with the quality of some sound cards of 2001, especially the new MacBook Pro, which has a certain upgrade. It's a pity that the Mac only reserves a 3.5mm external connection. If Tim Cook figures it out one day, there will be an I/O expansion module, and many sound cards will cry and faint in the toilet. Next, let's briefly talk about the running score. First, the running score of Cinebench 2024 is chosen because it can run full CPU performance and is closer to the limit of enabling. Single-core M3 Max has surpassed M1 Ultra by a lot. Compared with the previous generation M2 Max, it has increased by 16%. It has also surpassed the single-core score of M2 Ultra. Multi-core has caught up with M1 Ultra, which means that M1 Ultra can basically be laid off. Compared with the previous generation M2 Max, it has increased by 62% directly, which should be the upgrade of Max since ancient times. End the GPU test of Cinebench 2024 because the M3 series is equipped with a new generation of GPU, built with a new architecture, introduced a new dynamic cache, improved the average interest rate of GPU, and improved the performance of professional APPs and games. The improvement of M3 Max is often obvious. M2 Max has increased by 65%, and its score is twice that of M1 Max, which directly surpasses the GPU score of M2 Ultra. As a result, I have two Mac Pros and Mac Studios with top M2 Ultra cores at the same time, and I can't calm down for a long time. And the difference between the multiple scores of Mac Pro and Mac Studio is no more than 1%. Under overload, the fan speed is no more than 2,000 RPM. Most of the time, the fan is basically not rotating, even less than 500 RPM, which means that the Mac Pro is almost zero without expansion. And Apple made it clear that the M2 Ultra is already very strong and does not need a graphics card, so it will not produce a single graphics card. Do you understand my pain? Moreover, in the Cinebench 2024 rendering test, it is also found that the power consumption of M3 Max is up to 51W, while that of M2 Max is only 32W. The fan speed corresponds to 2,000 RPM and 4,000 RPM, and the fan finally rotates. Does this mean that Apple did not want to squeeze the performance of M2 series before? Because we are a professional frequency channel, so next, I will continue to test the frequency software. First record and mix, I built a 180-track 24-bit 192kHz track in Pro Tools software to record at the same time. M2 Ultra CPU accounts for 11%, memory accounts for 13%, M3 Max CPU accounts for 13%, memory accounts for 19%, the M1 Ultra CPU accounts for 14%, and the memory accounts for 19%, the M2 Max CPU accounts for 23%, and the memory accounts for 25%, the M2 Pro CPU accounts for 34%, the memory takes up 49% of the power, and all 5 Macs can realize smooth recording. When we attach FabFilter Equalizer and Compressor plugins to 30 tracks, M2 Ultra CPU accounts for 21%, memory accounts for 31%, M3 Max CPU accounts for 16%, and memory accounts for 36%. The M1 Ultra CPU accounts for 17%, the memory accounts for 37%, the M2 Max CPU accounts for 38%, the memory accounts for 41%, and the M2 Pro CPU account for 59%, and the memory account for 77%. In this case, neither the CPU nor the memory is full. But although M2 Pro can operate smoothly in most cases, but there are already some cases of stuttering. In this round of test, the CPU scheduling of M3 Max is different from that of M2 series. It will schedule one core first, and the fan speed will also be increased. As the load increases, the fan speed will be relatively lower, and then other cores will be scheduled. Ask the next geek babe. This may be due to power consumption and the reason why the cluster changes, so if the running performance can be perfect below the decision core, there is no need to cross the cluster, because cross the cluster will cause more delay and more power consumption. But this kind of recording test is more extreme. Basically, these 5 Macs can cope with normal recording. In the actual mixing, we found a lot of complex publishing level body sound mixing. These 5 Macs can also cope smoothly. Even M1 Pro and M2 Max do not need to rush to upgrade. Like doing a complex panoramic sound soundtrack mix because the number of channels is twice that of body sound. Plus, the track is usually 100 tracks. The performance of M1 Ultra can be brought into play. Arrangement. Basically, all the complex demonstrations of 5 Macs running Logic Pro are smooth, so that there is no problem in bringing in the arrangement creation. We still brought out a very expensive synth plugin. I found a program with more pad, replaced the pad with Serum, and adjusted the oscillator settings to 4x, totaling 12-track Serum Pad and 120-track other programs play at the same time. Sound card buffer size is set to 32 low, M2 Ultra CPU ratio is also 12%, and the memory ratio is only 21%. M3 Max's CPU ratio is 10%, and the memory ratio is 23%. M1 Ultra has 12% CPU ratio and 25% memory ratio. M2 Max has 24% CPU ratio and 45% memory ratio. The M2 Pro has 38% CPU and 71% memory. Below this limit, only the M2 Pro's Mac Mini will occasionally stutter, and the other four Macs can handle it. Once again, we replaced the program's All Strings and Winds, a total of 40 tracks, with East West Hollywood, with the M2 Ultra at 31% CPU and 36% memory, the M1 Ultra at 33% CPU and 44% memory, M3 Max has 36% CPU and 47% memory, M2 Max has 43% CPU and 61% memory, M2 Pro with 79% CPU and 100% memory. In this case, the Mac Mini of M2 Pro has been squeezed. The other four Macs can play and operate in real time as normal. Therefore, the Arranger, third, still has a certain demand for memory capacity. In terms of frequency and core performance, I feel that M2 Pro and even M1 Max are completely enough. However, if the system memory is only 32GB, it will be subject to the memory capacity to deal with some of the third more types of arrangers. Therefore, suggested that arranges the music the friends first to choose expands the memory capacity as far as possible, will raise the processing to arrange the program the upper limit. If you do some simple arrangement of streaming songs and make Logic Pro built-in source, even the M1 series of Macs can handle it. To sum up, in fact, Mac has already had excessive performance in the field of frequency. Apple's M3 series is mainly aimed at AI, games, special effects, modeling, and other fields. With hardware, accelerated ray tracing, and new architecture of GPU, the experience has indeed been upgraded. However, light frequency, cut our channel video. In fact, the M1 Ultra, years ago, can be fully competent for our needs. The point is not stuck. So do you want to upgrade M3 or not? If you are a Mac user with Intel Core, do not consider upgrading. The experience will be improved qualitatively. If it is M1, M2 series users, in fact, the need to upgrade is really not, then the possible change is not likely to boast, wow, 3 Type-C connected to the new Deep Space MacBook Pro. Okay, that's all the content of this video. If you feel the content is good, don't forget to like and forward. We will do it next time.